Welcome to Monday with Michelle on Outlet the Great. Hope you guys had a really good weekend. This video for me today is probably going to be a little short because I've been singing all weekend for both of my jobs, and my throat's a little run down. This past weekend was Yom Kippur, and so Friday night Kol Nidre service, which goes on for hours and hours, and then you sing all day Saturday. And then Sunday at my church job, did the services in the morning, then had to come back and sing an even song in the afternoon. So by last night, I was just done, you know. But I'm not complaining. It's a great job, and I'm glad I'm able to do what I love to do in life. So this week, our topic is a topic that was given to us back when we had our contest by Laurence. And it's I condensed the comment into kind of the key points. It says, Outlet the Great is all about coming out, but when is one truly out? Personally, I've had to deal with quite a bit of skepticism from lesbians, family members, and others. Now that I have told a range of people in various areas of my life, I consider that I am out, regardless of how others react to my information. What's it been like for you? And are you out enough for you? And the very last sentence in that topic is what really made me pick that topic, because we all have varying degrees of what we consider is enough outage for ourselves, you know. Some people are happy with no one knowing, and some people want everybody to know. And I'm not sure why that is exactly. It's just a reflection, I think, of our own personalities. And just like some people are more outgoing than others, and some are more private. So yes, for me personally, I am out enough for me. And that's pretty out, because everybody at all my jobs knows not only that I'm with a woman, but that we had an official wedding, and that I used to be married to a man. And, you know, for people that touch my life in any way, they usually know very quickly. Also, most of my students and their parents know. And somebody's getting pulled over outside. We live right down the street from a major school, two major school zones. And so people are getting busted for running the school zone speeds like nonstop around here. But at least they're stopping them, so that's good. I think that to be out to your students, you know, once they get to a certain age, I mean, if they're really little tiny kids, they don't know, which is good because they don't need to know. But like the parents and stuff, they figure it out pretty quickly. And that's pretty out to me, you know, and that feels really good, because the last thing that I want to have happen is somebody get kind of blindsided once they've been a student of mine or parents of students of mine for a while. And then all of a sudden realize that I'm gay and I have a partner and my studio is here in our home, and I don't want any issues about that because of the fact that I am a teacher, and there's a lot of sticky areas when it comes to being a teacher and working with kids and being gay. So I, like when I'm talking to someone on the phone for the first time, like when they're calling to ask if I have any, you know, slots available to teach their children, I immediately go into the, well, my partner and I are both piano teachers, and her and I have recitals twice a year, and if I don't have room, maybe she does. You know, I try to get that in the conversation right away. Now, some people may say, well, you know, my sexuality is my private business. I don't want everybody at work knowing my private business. But I think because I teach children, I have to almost make it more for public consumption than I probably would otherwise. I'm not embarrassed about being gay. I'm not embarrassed of being married to a woman. But I think I'm probably more out than I just would be if I didn't have children that I was dealing with on a regular basis. Because the last thing I want is anything to be, you know, hidden about that. I don't want anybody to be, you know, bamboozled into thinking I'm some straight person with a husband. So I think probably my one aspect of my career has me more out than others. Now, for someone who works, now I work privately, I have my own studio and I'm a private teacher. I think if you were to work in a public school setting, especially, you know, until you get to university level, you probably have to be in the closet, or you have to be kind of subdued because of the flack that you would get from not so much the students, but parents of those students. So it's kind of weird. You know, it's a complete dichotomy. So yes, that's how I'm going to answer that question. And I'm happy that I'm that out. Everybody that I've talked to, at least in my face, hasn't really had any qualms about me or being out. And I think a lot of it is in the way you deliver your information. You know, if you're saying it just matter-of-factly, like, I'm wearing a blue shirt today, you know, this is really how important it is for someone else to know this information is seriously as important as what color shirt were you wearing. Because really it is none of their business. But being what it is, people seem to think that it is their business. And so I'm as open book as possible, just so that people can see that I'm as normal or not as normal as they are. Have a great week, everybody. Would love to hear your thoughts. Peace.